Hi, my name is Patrick. This specific video is to help you understand how to train for an IPM interview. Now, students have written the examination, so next stage would be the interview stage. So it's very important that you clear both the written test and the interview to get the admission. So don't ignore the interview. It can make or break in terms of your selection process. So this is a part of the series, the first part, where I'm talking about making a list. So I'll record a number of videos that should help you with regards to preparation for IPM interviews. So go to the videos and it'll give you a hint in terms of what is the direction you need to take for interview preparation. Right. So we have been training students for the management entrance, like for MBA entrance interviews, for IPM interviews, etc. We also train management students for their placements. So that's specifically PI. PI is the interviews. That written ability test and group discussion. That's what we train for. So what is the first step in the preparation for the interviews? I would say make a list. So make a list on what you want the panelists to know about you. Now normally what happens when we go for the interview, we feel that we will answer whatever the panelists will ask you. But that will be, you will be following their directions. It's very important that you would want to sell yourself in the interview, or you would want to mention your achievements, because in the end of the day, the panelists will select you only if they feel that you're a good candidate, which means you need to tell them about your achievements, if you have any achievements, or if you organized events anywhere, you held some position like head boy, head girl, or anything as such, you've got some certificates for some particular music, dance, or anything on that aspect. So know about yourself and find out what you want the panelists to know about you, so that you can come across in a positive light. So if you have done something good and you can mention that, that will always be put you in a positive light. Because I would want a student who has done something during his, you know, up to his 10th or 12th, and so that again take him, because management is all about, you know, getting involved in a lot of activities, and that should help. It is not that you have to have achievements. I've had students who don't have achievement but still made it. In that case, you need to be able to direct the interview. So you should find out what you want the panelists to ask you on. So maybe you have some hobby which you want them to ask you questions on. Some hobby, some interest, something which you have. Or some current issues that you're aware about, you want them to ask you questions on so that you can answer them. Or any events that you've organized, anything as such. So these are two areas that you need to make a list. One is what you want the panelists to know about you, something good about you. Try to put 5 points. It may not be great achievement. It could be small achievement that you have done. Give you an example. I remember we had a student who didn't have any great achievements as such. But when we probed him, we found out that he was organizing events in his locality. The Dahi event, Ganesh Otsav event. So he went about showcasing that in the interview, saying that he took initiative in organizing those events and went about organizing the whole thing. Put him in a positive light, because it shows that he can take initiatives, it shows that he can organize things, and that's what he got selected in the end. Okay, so look at something will be there in your past which will put you in a positive light, which you can bring out your qualities in the interview, which could help you in the interview process. Normally in the IPM interview, not a lot of students have great achievements, because it's up to 12th. A lot of people do a lot of activities after 12th. But if you have, it makes sense to showcase yourself. That will help you to get through the interview. Also, the areas that you want to ask you questions on, be prepared. So if you want them to ask you questions on hobbies, prepare on the hobbies. Same if you want them to ask you question on interest, prepare on that. Or any current issues, then keep up to date with regards to newspaper, what is happening around. That should hopefully help. Right? So if you can go about this, that should help you with regards to interview preparation. Thank you. We'll have more such interview preparation videos that should help you with regards to preparation. So we'll release that one by one. Start with this, start with making a list, and then we can go with the subsequent process. Thank you.